Science Summary. A study concludes that the rates of emissions reductions need to be increased by at least 80% beyond the so-called nationally determined contributions, or NDCs, for Earth likely meeting the 2 degrees Celsius upper target of the Paris Agreement. NDCs are non-binding national climate goals and a core part of the international agreement. The study's authors estimate the probability of staying below 2 degrees Celsius warming by 2100 to be 5% with current trends. If the NDCs of all signatory systems were met and these trends continued after 2030, the estimated probability would be 26%. Experts have recommended fundamental structural changes of the socioeconomics of global civilization and related mechanisms, such as of accountability, as well as pursuing a path for a maximum of 1.5 degrees of warming rather than 2 degrees. Scientists report that air pollution by nitrogen dioxide could be a so-called technosignature by which one could detect extraterrestrial civilizations. On Earth, nitrogen dioxide is mostly emitted from the use of human technology. Nitrogen dioxide levels high enough to be detected on a habitable planet could therefore be a marker of a civilization, if it also uses combustion engines burning fossil fuels or similar technology, and is at a stage close to where humanity is now. Difficulties in detecting such signatures include clouds and aerosols, reducing the detectability and time spans of nitrogen dioxide levels high enough, such as possibly those 40 years ago on Earth, likely being short, making such signatures highly rare and distant, even if humanity-like civilizations are commonplace. Astronomers report that the hypothetical planet mass object, usually called Planet 9, in the outer region of the solar system may not exist at all. The observational data that suggested its existence was found to be not significant evidence for its existence and, according to their study, likely was selection bias. They find that the astronomical bodies, apparently clustering as if influenced by the gravitational pull of a planet mass object, were observed because these were the ones telescopes could detect or searched for, and not because they were actually clustered this way. They used computer simulations and telescopic data to test whether 14 such detected objects are consistent with simulated random distributions of objects with orbits further out than that of Neptune, without the influence of a Planet 9. They found these to be explainable by selection bias, concluding that we just find things where we look. However, some scientists argue that albeit the data set about relevant far-out objects is small, and too small for any robust conclusions so far, the data still indicates the presence of gravitational pulling there, which could also explain some other unsolved problems of the solar system. Researchers report finding sessile life forms on a rock almost 900 meters below the ice of Antarctica, 1.2 kilometers below the surface. These appear to be sponges and possibly bacterial mats. The findings are extraordinary due to the unprecedented depth below ice, the unclear way of how nutrients from distant places where photosynthesis is possible can reach them, and how the life forms got there. It may have implications for astrobiology and the study of the emergence of multicellular life on Earth. Scientists report the sequencing of the oldest DNA so far, that of two mammoths that lived over a million years ago. Parts of their ancient genomes preserved in Arctic permafrost were reconstructed using an algorithm with elephant genomes and are about twice as old as the previously oldest DNA sequences. Analysis of the DNA provides insights into long-term evolutionary history, such as revealing a new mammoth species that is a hybrid between the woolly mammoth and a previously unknown genetic lineage of mammoth. The oldest DNA recoverable via preservation by permafrost is thought to be 2.6 million years. Spacecraft of the United Arab Emirates, China, and the U.S. arrive at Mars. The spacecraft of the United Arab Emirates will remain in orbit around the planet. China's lander is planned to land in May, and the U.S. spacecraft landed in a crater thought to have once contained water. The payload of the latter spacecraft also contains a helicopter drone, the first to be operated on another planet. Due to the delay of signals from operators on Earth, it uses autonomous control during its flights. Its rover, Perseverance, is planned to prepare the first Martian samples for later retrieval. Goals of the missions include the study of the Martian environment and the search for evidence of prior life on Mars. Teams of cognitive scientists report having established two-way communication with people undergoing a lucid dream, a dream in which one is conscious of being in a dream. During dreaming, they were able to consciously communicate with experimenters via eye movements or facial muscle signals, were able to comprehend complex questions, and use working memory. Such interactive lucid dreaming could be a new approach for the scientific exploration of the dream state and could have applications for learning and creative work. Scientists report that the short global geomagnetic reversal, or geomagnetic excursion, of Earth's magnetic field about 42,000 years ago, in combination with periods of low solar activity, caused major extinctions and changed the atmospheric ozone concentration and circulation, driving further environmental changes. It may have contributed to the extinction of the Neanderthals and appearances of cave art at the time. For about 700 years during the excursion, auroras were visible across the world, not just the polar regions, and levels of harmful radiation increased worldwide. During the La Champ event, human ancestors may have been puzzled by colorful skies and been driven to caves to evade damaging ultraviolet rays. Phase 3 trial results show Russia's Sputnik V vaccine to be 92% effective against COVID-19. While the early approval of the vaccine was widely criticized for coming ahead of any trial results with a substantial number of participants, the new Phase 3 trial results indicate that the two-jab vaccine is highly safe and effective. Scientists detect mutated versions of the variant of concern from the UK, which may reduce the effectiveness of current vaccines, but are very rare, with only 11 out of 214,000 sequences of the novel variant of concern containing the mutation. Researchers demonstrate a first prototype of quantum logic gates for distributed quantum computers. Merging quantum computers to a joint processing unit could circumvent limitations of single quantum computers. A study using a high spatial resolution model and an updated concentration response function finds that 8.7 million global excess deaths in 2018, or a fifth, were due to air pollution generated by fossil fuel combustion, which is significantly higher than earlier estimates and includes spatially subdivided mortality impacts. However, a more nuanced assessment of mortality impacts in terms of contribution to death, rather than a number of deceased, may be more adequate. In a scientific review, researchers conclude that Homo sapiens does not have a single origin in terms of ancestor birthplaces being limited to a small geographic region, and that current knowledge about long, continuous, and complex emergences of characteristics is consistent with a range of evolutionary histories. For instance, such emergences can often have occurred in parallel, highly asynchronously, and/or gradually. Researchers report the development of a wearable thermoelectric generator with characteristics that make it a candidate for devices continuously harvesting energy from body heat as well as solar energy, with potential applications that include powering wearable electronics. Researchers report that the variant of the NOVA1 gene present in Neanderthals and Denisovans has a major impact on neurodevelopment after reintroducing the archaic gene into brain organoids via CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing. Genetic mutations, like a substitution in that gene during the evolution of the modern human brain, may underlie traits separating modern humans from extinct Homo species. Scientists report that the impactor that caused the dinosaur extinction may be a fragment of a disrupted comet rather than an asteroid. They show that a fraction of long-period comets is tidally disrupted after passing close to the sun, producing fragments that cross Earth's orbit. A philosopher of cognitive science and applied ethics calls for precautionarily banning all research that directly aims at or knowingly risks the emergence of artificial consciousness on postbiotic carrier systems until 2050. He writes that this global moratorium on synthetic phenomenology could be gradually refined and prolonged, but does not describe any mechanisms of global enforcement of the proposed regulations or consider biotic or semibiotic systems. The proposal aims to limit suffering risks, which are risks of astronomical amounts of suffering. Researchers confirm that the Atlantic meridional overturning circulation, which includes the Gulf Stream, is at its weakest since about 1,000 years ago and is experiencing unprecedented weakening, likely due to global warming. This could result in more extreme weather events, including heat waves and intense winters, and cause the circulation to reach a tipping point.